Everybody out there on YouTube, this is Cheetawolf on his famous, well, not really famous, messy workbench. I mean, seriously, you should see this. In fact, let's actually clip my iPod off of its tripod. Actually, I've got this little, I'm using my $300 headphones as an external microphone because, frankly, the one in the case sucks. So, anyway, let's unclip my iPod from the messy workbench and arrangement I have for recording video. The stand thing I got for $5, this external battery I got for $20, and this little thing which serves as an external microphone, and this button here is like a remote, which is all pretty cool. Let's snap iPod. But that's not what we're all about here. Sorry if the audio sounds weird, I'm using this as a microphone. Scrape-tastic. Anyway, I made a stop at our local Dollar Tree on the way home from school, and came across these. It's Whack-A-Pack. Surprise greetings. Caution, adult supervision required. Well, I'm technically legal and an adult, so I can supervise myself, thank you very much. Includes, that you can't see, 4 self-inflating balloons. The basic thing is, you hit the packet, it expands, and a balloon comes out. But, frankly, I don't see how this could work. It just seems to be one of those fart bombs, or thing, you know, you squeeze it, it's got a chemical reaction inside, makes CO2 with baking soda and vinegar or something, and it makes it explode. I don't see how a balloon could possibly inflate from one of those. Maybe it won't at all, and it'll just fail. Let's find out. Put the microphone down, give me all the extra crinkly plastic. How do you open these things? Oh, it's got a weird tear flap on the back. Keep these. This should have been a job for the golden scissors! Let's grab the second one from the left. See, okay, so basically it works as, set it down, whack the pack, poof, and watch and wait. Get used to having the microphone down there, not tripling. Okay, so I'm assuming you just put it down here and it does a thing. Okay, just put it on the workbench, the smoothest of all known surfaces. Let's put the microphone next to it so you can hear it extra crinkle as it expands. Go! Actually works, then I swear. I don't see how it could possibly work though. Well, it's still going. It hasn't blown apart yet. Probably shouldn't be that close to it. Can you hear that? It's fizzing. It's really tight. Yeah, that's not working so well. Maybe it pops down there with that little heat seal. Well, it's moving. It's still making fizzy noises. Oh, it's doing something. See why it says wait on it? That's ridiculous. It even comes with the world's cheapest golden string to tie up the balloons that you don't get because it won't inflate. Let's poke it. Maybe it just needs some help. If I press down on it. Oh, that's really not going. Work. Shake it maybe? Get the chemical reaction. Oh, there we go. Just needed a bit of help to get the chemical reaction going, and it did indeed appear to work. That's actually not half bad. That's kind of cool, I suppose. Reaction going. That's not bad at all, actually. Yeah. For some reason, for whatever stupid reason, I thought this would be like a full-size Mylar balloon coming out of that. Okay, well, that worked. It didn't leak inside the packaging. Put that down there. I wonder if it actually does have the same cut. I want to put this into something. Never mind. Let's put it on this little fireproof soldering plate I have. Oh, that was a stupid idea. It's full of liquid. What's in it? Tear it apart, find out. Yeah. Yeah, a little packet of probably some liquid in there and some powder. Doesn't smell like vinegar, though, so it's probably not baking soda and vinegar. Probably something a bit more efficient and lethal than that. Didn't say anything about the contents being non-toxic, but again, that's kind of a rarity for Dollar Tree stuff. Let's pour the water out. Maybe if it's on a more level surface, perhaps. Let's slam the next one and then quickly put it on my soldering platform. Oh, the side blew out! Did you see that? That's depressing. I hit it and the side immediately blew open and all the contents are... Maybe I can quickly get a look at it before it all explodes. Yeah! Oh, it's blown the side of the balloon out. That's pathetic. Okay, we're at 50%. Let's see if this thing gets a passing grade. Oh, that one inflated much faster. This one's promising. Oh! Oh, went up and hit the ceiling! This one's doing much better. It blew up and hit the ceiling. That's great. Tragically enough, it doesn't seem to be able to fully inflate on its own. Cut along with the chemical reaction a bit. Yeah. Oh, it's got stickers on it. Made in China is all you get. Made in China. Still fizzing. Okay, let's do one more. Let's just squeeze this one this time. There it goes. Stand back. Here we go. Oh, it hit the ceiling again. This time it fully inflated straight off the bat. That's really cool. Well, we got a... I'd call that a solid B+. This one passed super... Oh, it's actually... Oh, it's still going. Uh-oh. I'm actually concerned this one might burst. That's kind of cool. It's really neat. I wonder if these will pop, too. Oh, man, these are really tough to pop. Man. These are really meant for some serious pressure. Let's see if the, Yeah, this one kind of tried to inflate a little. That one actually inflated properly. That's cool. Let's bring in the golden scissors of justice. Bring in the golden scissors of justice for this one as well. Oh, that was anticlimactic. I was hoping for a massive explosion. Oh, yep, I see it in there. There's still a reaction going on. It's fizzing in there. Well, anyway, That's Whack-A-Pack. Surprise gifts. Even though it's not a surprise, because it says right there it's a balloon. Well, that was fun, I suppose, huh? Hope the microphone worked.